would like to bring up our education director, Brother Ahmed Hassan, who has been a part of the Dar al-Hijra team for quite some time, alhamdulillah. He is one of the original founders of Dar al-Hijra Islamic Center and established the first Quran school. He is currently the vice chairman in the board of directors and serves as the chair of the education committee. Dr. Hassan is a professor in mathematics at Howard University. Previously, he taught at Trinity University and DeVry University in DC. Dr. Hassan teaches a tafsir class that is open to the community every other Sunday. Additionally, he's taught fiqh and sirah in the Somali language. Without further ado, Dr. Ahmed Hassan.
Shukran. Thank you, Sister Aisha, and thank you for our guest, brothers and sisters, for this great event tonight. Bismillah bihi nasta'in. I'm going to be brief, inshallah ta'ala. First of all, our education department, we focus what we call about how to revive the message of the masjid. We call Ihya Risalat al-Masjid. The masjid has a risala. So we focus, inshallah, how to revive this risala of the masjid. And we put main emphasis in four categories. Number one, al-ilm, knowledge. Number two, al-fahm al-amiq, ma'atadabbur, deep understanding and empower, and also pondering on what we are learning. Number three is at-tatbiq al-amali. So what we learn it, we have to practice it. Knowledge without practice has nothing. So we need also to practice what we learn. And the fourth part is at-tabligh. You have to give this message, we learn it to the outside world. You know, Islam focuses as ilm, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. And when we come is to Islam, Prophet alayhi says in hadith, sahih, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا فَقِهُ فِي الدِّينِ. So the best knowledge is what? قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَقَالَ رَسُولَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So we are going to focus this to teach our, particularly our young and youth, to learn this dear deen, particularly in this society. In this society. That's why we bring every time scholars in our community each month. You know, as you know in the hadith of the hadith Jibreel, when Jibreel came to the when a man came, I'm going to be short on, and he asked the Rasul alayhi sallam three questions. Ma huwa al-Islam, ma huwa al-Iman, ma huwa al-Ihsan. After this person left, Rasul asked the Sahaba, do you know who was this person? He told Allah Rasul alayhi. He said, hadha Jibreelun ataakum yu'allimukum deenukum. Jibreel only came only three, he asked only three questions. Al-Islam, al-Iman, al-Ihsan. And this is what the ulama says, arkanu deen, not arkanu Islam, arkanu deen. There are 12, 5, 6, and 1. To bring you for this, we take in this sunnah, we bring ulama to teach us our deen. So, and these are very good scholars. And subhanAllah, last year we added in our program, we have two seminars about Al-Quran al-Karim, and we brought greatest scholars of Qurra in Dar al-Hijra. They came twice Dar al-Hijra, and this inshallah also a year we're going to planning to bring these scholars of Qurra. They'll be inshallah on Dar al-Hijra on May, I think it's May the 9th. These are great scholars, and most of them are Zahra'iyya. And we encourage because to learn our Qur'an, because Qur'an is the main source of knowledge. As I said, we need also to understand al-fahm al-amir. We need to tadabbur, afala tadabbur al-Qur'an. We have to tadabbur ayat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah says, قُلْ انظُرُوا مَاذَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. So we have to look ayat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi al-afaqi, fi al-anfus. So we have to understand the deep knowledge of this. And the third one is, as I said, tabligh. We have to what? Al-amal, I'm sorry, al-amal. We have to do what we're learning. We have to practice what we're learning. If you learn today an ayah, practice it. If hadith, practice it. Otherwise, it's going to be yawm al-qiyamah, it's still against you. So we have to practice what we learn our deen. And I said the fourth part of what is it, tabligh. We have to give this message to non-Muslims, also to ourselves and our neighbors. As Allah says, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةِ وَأَنَا وَاتَّبَعَنِ. So we have to message this Quran and Dindi to others. Rasulullah says, بَلِّغُوا عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. So we have to give the people bringing around us, they wanted to learn, but they wanted the resources and who to give them. Wallah, every time I go in my campus, Howard University, I make dua to the students. They are lost. Nobody's telling them deen. Nobody's telling them, so they're waiting us. Who's going to tell the deen? If you are silent, yani. So we have to give this measure to your co-workers, to your friends, any place you are, tell them something. Tell them something. Every time when I teach something, even has nothing to do with, for example, I'm talking about something about, what do you call, compound interest, interest in mathematics. I talk about what? Riba. Why riba is very bad? Because mathematical also is wrong. You see, I show them, you see, how is wrong, guy. So try to always talk in a nice way, the people. Lastly, I have to tell you that, alhamdulillah, we have also a team with me working this subject. With me is Dr. Ahmed Mustafa. He's helping me. We have Sister Khadija also helping us. Also, we have a Mu'ad, a Sayyid with us, and a Khura Mukhtar. So we have now, alhamdulillah, other four brothers and a brother and a sister going to help us this program. And this year, inshallah, we have to have a great message, inshallah, preparing. Barakallahu feekum. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.